This episode of D News is proudly brought to you by Subaru. Sometimes science has to ask the hard questions, like, how do you cure a legless person of a foot cramp? Howdy everyone, Trace here for D News. Amputations are more common than you'd think, mostly from diabetes, trauma, birth defects, and tumors. Some estimates reach over 150,000 annually in the US. Aside from the pain and rehabilitation of the healing process, amputees have to deal with their own brain's confusion over the loss of a limb. Phantom limb pain is when a person feels pain in a limb they don't actually have. There's literally nothing there, but the brain still feels that missing limb. Their toes might be moving, their fist might be clenched tightly, or they could even feel like it's spontaneously getting shorter. It's all in their head though, but it feels real to them. It just sounds terrible. At the moment, treatments include relaxation techniques and mental exercises, but a new technology from Sweden could really help people who suffer from this phantom limb pain. A research group is using augmented reality in combination with electronic sensing equipment to give people back their limbs in virtual reality. The technology uses sensors and asks the amputee to complete a computer game which uses their limb. It senses the nerve input from their brain and responds as if they were using that missing piece. Once they've trained themselves to recognize their virtual limb, therapists can help them train and rehabilitate themselves. A clenched fist can be relaxed, and the patient can literally see their virtual fist relaxing too. Augmented reality therapy works because our brains are easily fooled into believing a virtual arm is our own. This is a new technique using an old trick. The premotor cortex uses information gathered by your senses to keep an awareness of our own bodies. It uses this to determine if the hand in front of you is your hand or someone else's. Scientists have known for a long time that given the absence of feeling or weight, the premotor cortex favors visual information. Thus, in the past, a simple mirror has been used to accomplish what they're now doing with virtual reality. A mirror would be set up to mimic the missing limb, and doctors found mirror therapy was even more effective than drugs to treat phantom limb pain. This is yet another example of technology being kind of generally awesome. Virtual reality is being used by therapists to help cure people with phobias in a safe environment and help reduce fear, anxiety, and avoidance in PTSD patients. It's even been used to treat burn victims by helping them explore a snowy paradise just to cool down. The brain is easily fooled, and we can totally use that power for good. By the way, humans are not the only ones who can benefit from a little technology TLC. Techzilla's Patrick Norton teamed up with Subaru to customize 3 high-mileage Subaru cars so that their charity-minded owners can keep doing their thing and helping the world. Check out his handiwork on the Second Chance Subaru series at revision3.com/Subaru. But back to augmented reality. What would you use it for? What if I could play as, like, Goro from friggin' Mortal Kombat, moving 4 arms using my brain? That'd be sweet. Tweet us your ideas at DNews or tell us in the comments below. Make sure that you subscribe for more, and we will see you next time.